Senator Sanders, this is a bill which has never once had a majority of Americans favor it. It's a bill which the Democrats lost Teddy Kennedy's seat in a special election over. It's a bill which cost the Senate, the House Democrats 63 seats. And in the most recent polls, you've had by about 45 to 27, the American people say it's going to make their health worse, not better. I mean, isn't there a point here where the American people deserve some respect in slowing down the implementation of something?
Well, I would look at it another way, Newt. The way I look at it is the Republicans have now tried 42 times to defund it without success. They went to the Supreme Court. The Supreme Court ruled it constitutional. They ran a presidential election on this issue, and they lost. But let me be very clear. I voted for Obamacare. But to be very honest with you, I'm not going to argue with anybody who says that it is too complicated. I am an advocate of a Medicare for All single-payer program. I think Obamacare is a good Republican Romney-type program, which has worked in Massachusetts. It's a moderate program which addresses some needs. But let me be clear, and I want to throw this out to you guys.
Okay.
As you know, the United States of America, our very great country, is the only nation in the entire industrialized world that does not guarantee health care to all people as a right. Second of all, we end up spending almost twice as much per capita on health care as do the people of any other nation. Thirdly, our health care outcomes and our life expectancy falls behind many other countries who spend a lot less. So my own view is that we should learn from the rest of the industrialized world, say that every man, woman, and child is guaranteed health care, expand Medicare to all people.
So,
that's my view.
Well, let me ask you this, because you're in Vermont, you're right on the edge of Canada.
Yes.
Canada's obviously a model. Two pieces of data. One, the Canadian system's going up at about 8% a year in cost right now. And two, 43,000 Canadians last year came to the United States for various things they couldn't get in Canada. Now, my question for you would be, if we went to national health care, where would the Americans go who needed to get things they couldn't? I mean, the Canadians right now can come here because this is still a relatively open system.
Let me respond in this way. I was the first, actually, when you were Speaker, I was in the House. You know what I did? I took Vermonters over the Canadian border. Do you know why? Because women who were dealing with breast cancer were paying 10 times more for breast cancer drugs in the United States than they were in Canada. Second of all, some of those trips from Canada into the United States are paid for by their government. Third point that I would make is that certainly the Canadian system is not perfect. There is no healthcare system in the world that's perfect. But they have had, as you well know, a very conservative prime minister in Canada, right, for many, many years. Now, if you had a conservative prime minister who thought their system was so terrible, I would have imagined he would have repealed it years ago. But he understands it would be political suicide because the Canadian healthcare system is popular in